Well, I said in the last video I bought a new bike, and many of you left in the comments what you thought it was. I should think about 90 to 95% of you said it was an e-bike. One or two of you said it was a gravel bike or a folding bike or even a BMX. I think only about one or two of you got it right. No, it's not an e-bike. I haven't gone for an e-bike because I'm very fortunate. Although I'm almost 60 years of age, I'm 60 next month, I'm still relatively fit. So I've got two good legs, and I'm really enjoying this cycling. So I must apologise to any of the motorcyclists that are watching, because I've not done a motorcycle video for some time. I am going to do a motorcycle video probably next week, but I've really can't go off on a tangent and started doing the cycling. I'm really enjoying the cycling, and I found the cycling is just, I'm able to really get immersed into the countryside. I can get off the road. I can, if I stop and see a nice view, I can just stop, get off the bike, take the photograph, do whatever I want to do. The bike is such a versatile tool for getting to places, and it's just the right speed. You know, I think walking is just a bit too slow, and the motorcycle perhaps a bit too fast, but the push bike is just right, I find. But I haven't given up on the motorcycles. There will be more motorcycle content coming soon, but I think going forward I'm going to be doing a lot of cycling, or videos containing cycling, because the bicycle is such a powerful tool. So anyway, it's not an e-bike, and the reasons why it's not an e-bike is, first of all, because of the type of cycling that I do. I'm not a road racer. I'm just me. I put my shoes, my socks like that, into my trousers, into my socks. That's me set up for cycling. And I go different places. You know, I might want to go down a farm track or across a field, and I've got to lift the bike over. An e-bike is very heavy. You've got to keep the thing charged up, and some of the times, you know, if you're doing a multi-day journey with overnight camps, wild camps, say, you're not going to have the ability to recharge the battery. So an e-bike is out of the question. But cycling for me is about physical fitness and exercise as well. So it's not an e-bike. It's not a gravel bike, but it was a bike which had to go in between what the others do. My old touring bike is just a road bike. My MTB bike, mountain bike if you like, is just that, a mountain bike. I think I saw a flash of lightning then. They're specific for different tasks, but this bike I've got, it goes in between, and it will do a lot of other things as well. So I'm going to thunder. I did see a flash of lightning. So it's very versatile, and I'll cut to the quick. This is it here. Quick reveal. It's a Brompton. It's a folding bike. I've known about them for a while. I've done the reviews, looked at all the reviews. People really love these bikes, and my friend Dave's got one, and I had a test ride of that a few weeks ago, and I could immediately see why they like them. It's such a practical all-round bike. We went on an adventure with our folding Brompton bikes a few days ago, and took them across all sorts of terrain, even down old gravelly canal towpaths. It did it. I wouldn't say it's ideal for that, but it did it. If I had the choice, I'd probably take the mountain bike for that sort of journey next time. But people are doing multi-day adventures. They're cycling hundreds and hundreds of miles on these simple folding bikes. but they're exceptionally practical. On the front of the bike, it's got this thing called a T-block. If anyone that's got a Brompton, I'm probably boring you, so you have to forgive me, but a lot of my viewers probably haven't seen them before. And it's specific to this bag. And this bag is just designed to slot onto that T-block. Just like that. So you can take that into the supermarket, you can pull it along like that, put your shopping in your bag, and away you go. But the actual bike itself has also got a rack on the back. So the front bag will take 10 kilograms, the back rack will take 10 kilograms. So you've got 20 kilogram payload. It's a real mule of a bike, it's a work tool. Guy on YouTube called the Brompton Traveller, travels all around the world, he packs his bike up, sticks it on the plane, he goes all around the world, and he's got his rucksack on the back and the tea bag on the front, and he'll do 10, 12, 15 day adventures cycling thousands of kilometres. Anyway, I'll unpack the bike for you, you can see how it looks, how it unfolds, and then we'll get on with the adventure. An ingenious design. This is one of those things which was, the inventor got it right from the get-go, I think, really. So the handlebar stem folds up. And it's clamped into place. The seat comes up. The seat's it's got a cut out inside, so it's set up exactly from my height. That's something you do when you buy the bike. You get this insert and you cut it so that it allows the seat post to come up to a certain height. And that's set up for my height. And the bike itself just unfolds. And you've got another clamp. You clamp that. And then that's it. The bike is now ready for pedaling. Another flash of lightning. There's the tea bag, goes on the front. On the back, you've got your rucksack. It's a fantastic tool, it really is. I'm so impressed with the design and the build quality of it. This is the basic model. They're not cheap. You can go online and find out for yourself. Thunder. Anyway, now we'll go on to the adventure. Here he is, look, my old mate Dave. I've known Dave since he was 4 years old. Anyway, we're setting off, we're about to set off. We've only got 100 miles to cycle with an overnight camp on Brompton folding bikes. Parked at the River Ray. Right on the outskirts of Swindon now.
No, I love these sort of old railway lines. It's up by my mum, there's two or three railway paths like this.
Yeah.
One or two are a little bit bumpy in places, but you can quite easily take a Brompton along there, yeah.
It's had a few additions and things done to it over the years, hasn't it?
Yeah.
It's quite an interesting history to a lot of these little cottages.
I reckon so. Thank you.
well out of the town now. We've just come across Ravens Wood to stop here for a bit of a break. And then the next big town we enter is Malmesbury. Climb up to Malmesbury, making it look easy. This is Malmesbury. Time for coffee and cake at Malmesbury Abbey. There we go, look, a nice slice of carrot cake and a latte. What could be nicer?
That's it, we're leaving Malmesbury behind now, looking for Foxley Road, then picking up the old Foss Way, which takes us on to Bath, which is our next city. Foxley Road ahead. Not sure which way to go here. Which way do you reckon, Andy?
Well, if we go left, we've got to go down there and then go right, and or we go that way and then go left. So I think it's two sides of a square either way.
Yeah, yeah. I'll follow you.
Thank you. Alright. So we'll go this way then.
Oh, yeah.
It looks a bit more exciting.
We're just coming into the village of Norton, and apparently, according to the sign, there's a ford and also a lovely pub. The Vine Tree, right off the beaten track.
Car behind,
Dan. Car behind, Dave says. Okay. that's the old Foss Way you come along there, which was the road, the main sort of road area, and it goes around a bend, heads over in that direction. But our Foss Way, our old road, continues down here.
Yeah, yeah, we can get on down here, sound, I think.
That's the way, Dave, is it?
Yeah, you can keep going straight on down.
I like look at that, I can cycle along that all day.
It probably turns into a mud bath around the corner.
Hand slippery. Oh dear, we could do with a mountain bike along here.
Whose bright idea was this road?
It's got to be the M4 up there, Dave, isn't it?
The M4, yeah.
M4. Just going under the M4 motorway. I'd rather be going underneath it than be on it, that's for sure. Just rode past this gate and I saw a lovely view. I think it's a lovely view. Yeah, look at that. Isn't that lovely? What's that in there? Rocks? Oh yeah. Sometimes it's good to get off the bike and push up the hills. All good exercise. We're walking again up a steep hill. It gets to a point where the hill becomes too steep and you're putting too much pressure through the pedals, you're just better off getting off and walking. And to be honest with you, it's a good thing because it gives your backside a break from the saddle and it gives a different set of leg muscles a chance to work as well. So a change is always as good as a rest, as they say. Have a quick look. So it's right next to a busy road. We got this, and I would say, from what little knowledge I've got of it, it's probably a portal to a prehistoric burial mound, a long barrow perhaps. Yeah. Look at that. That's amazing. We just come down those steep hills, up and down, picking up speed, but you've got to be ever so careful, keep the brakes on. The wheels of the bike's got quite warm. Anyway, we're heading down towards Bath now, and there's just a lovely view if you can see it, all the way down there. There's another steep hill. really steep hill. Hiya. Here we are at Barthampton Meadows. Time for a pint in the pub. Cheers. Yeah, hey. Thanks to this folding bicycle, I've seen more of Bath in the last 30 minutes than I've seen of it in all my life. And I've been here a few times as well, so I'm really thankful for that. Hiya. It's always good to be thankful, you know. Heading towards the two tunnels, the Coombe Down Tunnel. I'm not sure what it's called, two tunnels, maybe there's just two tunnels. But it's 1.5 miles long. So always wanted to ride it, and we're not far away from the portal now.